Here, we'll be synthesizing an interesting mechanism where a vertical pipe is meeting a horizontal pipe and the two are intersecting, producing something like this, and we can even see the intersection curve here for the horizontal pipe. And we'll be deriving a mechanism that will allow us to cut this curve on this green pipe. Okay. Now here are some more details, like the axis of the two cylinders or the pipes, they are not intersecting, so they are skew and they are separated by some distance. So let us show those dimensions and just the intersection curve here. So the dimensions are given, they are separated by 60 mm, say. The radius of the vertical pipe is 150, while that of the horizontal pipe is 100 mm. Let us see how we can do this using a mechanism. Okay, we'll start deriving the mechanism now. For that, we are going to start with this horizontal cylinder or the pipe, and it is already cut the way we want. So when we have the mechanism, we can actually verify whether the intersection curve is accurately getting generated or not. Then we are going to mount this on a motor, so it starts rotating about its own axis, and that rotation we are going to feed to a disc, 1 to 1. So now these two rotating bodies are engaged 1 to 1. You can also see there is a pin mounted on this disc, so something can engage with it, and that is going to be this H-shaped slotted link. So as the disc rotates, this H-shaped link is going to sort of reciprocate back and forth, and for that we'll be providing some kind of guides here. So this is the resulting motion. Then we are going to have one more link attached to our H-shaped link, and that is for taking out the output from this particular setup. I have placed it some distance away from the slotted part, and that is nothing but the distance between the two axes. So now we are getting a projection. In addition to that, we are getting this extra distance E, or the eccentricity. And then this motion of this blue link that we have added, I'm going to feed to another part of the mechanism, a T-shaped guide over here. So you can see it is sliding back and forth within that T-shaped guide. And then we are going to put the last link that we need over here, this violet colored link, and attached to that you can notice is a cutter. So this is going to be the cutter, or maybe the marker, which will be moving on our pipe. And you can see it is faithfully following the curve that we wanted. Let us see this from another angle. And you'll see it is all the time keeping in contact with the curve. Interestingly, it disengages where the curve ends. So it is best seen in this view, the front view sort of. So let us see as it rotates. You can see this red part of the curve, it ends and then it is disengaging. Let me go to the front view proper. Let us observe it in the front view, and you can see where it ends, that is when the disengagement happens. Now it engages as the cutting curve starts. Let us see this in top view. So this is how the curve appears, the mechanism appears in the top view. And you can see it is following the curve. Of course, what we see here is the full intersection curve, the lower half as well as the upper half. While the mechanism is going to cut only the lower half this time. Once that is cut, or that is marked on the pipe, we'll have to turn the pipe by 180 degrees and get the other half of it. All the settings, like say the horizontal pipe's radius, the vertical pipe's radius, and the eccentricity between their two axes, can all be set on this mechanism to generate different scenarios. This I created about 25 years back, but had never animated that time, of course. Recently, I was invited for a speech, and I said I need something new, okay, to present to them, so I created this. Hope you enjoyed this. Thanks.